Hey Tech Fam, I just wanted to show you, I started doing this burger cake. I was just going to start it because it's going to be a big train wreck. So I thought I'd get a head start. But this is kind of turning out cool and I want to show you. I'll show you the plan for the cake later and then you'll understand why I'm doing this. But we're making a burger cake. It's going to be cartoon. We'll see. But I'm just making lettuce and it's turned out really good. So just doing another one. So basically, I don't know if you can see, I've just like cut out the 6-inch green fondant. I think I'm using fondant. And I've just like pinched all the edges. And now it looks like burger lettuce. So I've got two of those going. I think that will be enough for my burger. Want to do some tomato. I don't know if I want to do like tomato or like sauce. Red. I'm just using over the top fondant because I don't carry fondant often, so these little ones are perfect for this sort of thing. And you don't use it often, you just need like a little bit. I guess I could do sauce in like buttercream, so we could do that. I just kind of want it to like hang out the front of the cake. You don't have to see like the whole thing. Let's go find something the right size. Yeah, it'll look cool. Can probably do these in half anyway. I'm gonna need the whole thing because it's gonna be like poking out. Cool. Right. I'll let them dry. What else? Once I start constructing the cake, we'll do the patty and the cheese hanging over the patty, like a little square, I think. So I'll do that. I don't want the fondant to dry because I want to like, kind of hang it over organically is the word. Maybe I could do this as sauce. Which I'll need to do when the cake's done, since I won't be doing it now or else it's going to dry. Maybe one more tomato because I do want this cake to look cool from the back too. So, just and then I think we can start putting this cake together. Alright, I'm gonna get some things together and then I'll come back. Alright. I'm just doing a real quick crumb coat of this cake, just one layer. I'm using the Sweet Sticks flexible scraper, very handy for this sort of thing. And it'll all smooth out once you put the fondant on anyway. So probably get the fondant on now while it's wet. So I've just mixed together orange and brown. I don't know where my small roller is, so I'm using this one. I'm gonna do it reasonably thick. I don't love fondant as it is, so the easier the better for me, and the thicker is easier. Oh, tripod. So much stuff everywhere. Cut straight on. Not really measuring, just weeding up. Just a little bit. And I want to see, like, I want the this effect. I want it to look like a bun, right? Oh, bloody, I'm not too small. So I want it to still look like kind of separate layers. Done this on a 6-inch board. I mean, an 8-inch board, didn't need the 10-inch board. Anyway, I just did it just in case I needed more room. It's fine. Okay, so that is the bun. I'm going to keep this for the top of the bun. Alright, now I kind of want to do the next layer kind of separate. So I'm still going to put it straight on top, but I'm going to need to put like do the same thing basically, but
silly girl.
Do the same thing but on top of it. Um, So I'm just going to get my fondant kneaded and ready. So this is just straight up brown. Just kind of gone like a clay color. I'm going to add some brown into it, I think. Getting sweaty. Fondant. That's my hands. It's a bit like, doesn't look like a burger color. I don't want it to look like super burger, like burger colors, but it needs to be browner. I want it to contrast with the bun colour. That's done. Grab my cake and I'm gonna just with like a Stanley knife, my cake Stanley knife, not just a random Stanley knife, I'm just chopping the corners off of it. So it's more like rounded. Oops. Not too much though. So I'll just do a little bit of buttercream. I'm just doing this on another little 6-inch board. Without a turntable, apparently. Take this off. Scraper, get in. Oh, we're coming off. Right. basically going to do the same thing that we just did with the base. I can kind of pick this up because I haven't secured it to the board that I was working on, because we're going to put it back on the cake like so. I'm going to line up the seams at the back. Just make sure that I'm happy with how it looks. Now, I am going to be putting a 5-inch on top of this, so let me make sure that that is going to fit. Cool. Now, that's for bun. That is done. Yellow for cheese. I'm just going to wash my hands. I've got brown on them. Alright, yellow. I want this to be like a square. Like a slice of cheese or two. I've just got my scraper. I'm just going to do a right angle cut. do one on the back to cover up a seam. Better, isn't it? Oh, now move this out. Now this is the cool bit. I've got, put this back here. I've got this. I've got this to go in, like, in between the burger. So don't ask about Lord Frothington. It's for a one-year-old and he just froths on life, so they call him Lord Frothington, and it's the cutest freaking thing ever. But I've got, like, a smaller 5-inch cake that this is going to sit in, and then burger on the top, burger on the bottom. So this is going to go on what we just did. Cool? All right, it's just going to be plain buttercream and then this on the top, so I'm just going to do that. Alright, I just went and put that other little cake that's going to go in the middle in the fridge. So while that sets, I'm just going to do this one, which is going to be the top. So I've got my full cake. It's actually two layers because I already cut it in half. And I've just sculpted the top of it, as you can see. Just a real thin layer with this one because I don't want any bulging. I normally, PS, would never put fondant on buttercream. I would always do it over ganache. But ganache takes a long time. So we're not going to do that. We're just going to do buttercream. It's fine. Ganache also helps with, like, really sharp edges. If you're doing a sharp edge cake, this does not need to be sharp edged. At all. I'm also stoked that we're doing this in fondant because I don't know whatever order I upload this in. I did the same child's first birthday cake, and we did a cartoon birthday cake, so it looked like a birthday cake, like the drip and the candle and stuff. And I have never done a cartoon cake before. This is my second one. And I did it in buttercream and fondant black outline. Big mistake. It was so hard. So always use fondant for cartoon cakes. That's what we've come to the conclusion. All right, same color as earlier. The bun color. don't think I've got enough fondant. I don't want to make this too thin. Where's the way? Let's just see if I can stretch it. How far I can stretch it. Not enough. Damn. Alright. A bit more brown. Same color as the base. Not bad. Do not miss this, as in covering cakes in fondant like this. I freaking used to hate it so much. That's why I don't do fondant cakes anymore. I only use fondant for decoration purposes, but I guess this is the exception. But like trying to make the edges and there's no creases and like, oh, it was such a pain in the ass. I'm just gonna, literally just gonna fold this over because it doesn't matter. And it probably looks more effective. And then I'll just cut off the excess so it doesn't kind of cut off. Alright, so there is, I'll just scrape this away so I can just get it down. Over the top, there's a big air bubble in there. I guess that's what you get for using buttercream. It's not entirely smooth. There are air pockets in here. So I'm expecting like by this afternoon, I'm going to have to do a little bit of surgery on him. That's okay. I am anticipating that. Cool. All right, so just waiting for that cake to dry, to set in the fridge, and then I think we'll put it all together. All right. Let's do this thing. So this is the cake. Cool. Hopefully, yes, we can. Cool. So I'm hoping this will just kind of slip in here without much trouble. This came off. I was hoping that it would stay. This serves me right for being so rough for that. Gonna come off. But is it straight? All right, this is actually going to come off. Shove it back on. Damn it. Okay, we're good though. It's fine. All right, that's where we're at. Now I'm going to shove some skewers down him because I don't want him to go anywhere. Normally I would have thicker skewers than this, but of course I don't have any. That's really good. And I'm just going to cut like... No, I'm going to cut them completely because I will put more skewers when we put the top in. But I'll just put them straight through because I can cover them with whatever we're going to do on the top. This is why you don't push people's faces into cakes, P.S., because they have skewers. Timing. I actually put lettuce and tomatoes in the oven to dry out. So that's just them finishing in the oven. So I will go and get them out. Okay. So, I'm just going to put a little layer of stuff. So this is my lettuce. You can see it's like, it's hard. I'm not sure that we need to. Do we need to? I feel like it might crack on itself. I put, oh, might be right, we might be right. Okay. And then some tomatoes. I'm just mock stacking it at the moment so that I know that it's all jam. Alright. Bloody did it! We bloody did it. Alright. Okay. I might leave this for now because it's still a while away that I need to drop it. So I might come back to it to put the black stuff on because I don't want to leave it like this, so I'm going to dismantle it and then come back to it, I think. But good hustle, good hustle. Oh, that's gonna have to stay there.
That is stuck.
Okay. That's why we're gonna leave it for a little bit. Alright. So this is a weird angle, but I just filmed the cake without the black stuff on it for a reel. And so I have to keep my stand at the right height to like do it when I've finished it. So Instagram live. Now I've actually put the cake in the fridge, and I know you're not supposed to put fondant in the fridge because it gets wet, but that's what I want to happen because I feel like once I get the black stuff going, I want to be able to actually stick it to the cake because it's sticky. This is already sticky. And I want to do this. Alright, so I'm actually going to, because the lettuce is really thin, I'm actually going to use an edible pen. You can buy these just from the cake shop. I think that's my only one. Because I feel like it's gonna be easier on these smaller surfaces, the lettuce and the tomatoes. So I don't know if you can see that at all, you can't, but I've got such a dodgy hand at the moment, so shaky. Like, this is my old pen. I think I've got another one. No, I thought I had a new one. Gone with this one. Once I get this on top of the cake, I can fix it up. Always good to get a new pen if you really need it really, really dark, because they do dry out, and then if things aren't entirely dry, like this, it's a pain in the butt. At least this doesn't need to be literally exactly perfect because I just put, ooh, that was way too much. So water on it to make it more
wet. That's a bit better. Not really.
Now I want bring this for me. I want to do some seeds on the bun, but I don't want to complicate it for myself, so I might just do. Excuse me, why isn't this working? Do I need to do? I think that's about it. I'll go and get the cake in a minute, and then we'll secure the top to the bottom. This is taking forever. My oven. All right. So because the fondant is like a little bit sticky, like sticks. Black sticks easily to it. You have to screw around with getting sticky hands from. So I don't know whether I've uploaded it yet or not, but last time, I think I already said, P.S. Sorry, repeating myself. But last time I did this kind of cake, we did it in buttercream. It was so hard because once your fingers get like stuck to the buttercream, they get so sticky. So we did it in fondant. It's coming up a treat. Alright, I'm gonna go and get the cake and I can bang this on the top. Yeah, shortly. Once I finish this and ice some cupcakes.
Do you want a drink?
No, I'm good, thanks. Alright. Put that there. Sick already. hands are so shaky. Stop. Oh, shit me. My hands are too warm. I'm too hot. It's not working. What's the time there? Almost done. Now I'm going to put some sticks in here so this doesn't slide off the cake. But I feel like that's what's going to happen. I'm just seeing here, it's very, very lopsided. It's fine though. They have structure. And then I need to just finish the lettuce.